Thank you so much for having this opportunity to speak with you. I wanted to ask, how does UNIDO integrate gender equality in its projects around the world?
Yeah, thank you very much for the interview. I really appreciate this opportunity to talk about the UNIDO's program on gender issue. For UNIDO, we look at the gender mainstream very seriously. We started with the policy strategy. 2009, we General Conference adopted the policy on gender mainstream empowerment of women. 2015, this policy being improved again. Secondly, we identify the difference between men and women, what kind of needs from different groups. For women, of course, we identify the important thing. First is equal opportunity, access to the training programs, the capacity building, and also how to actually have opportunity to access to market. Based on this kind of analysis, we develop our programs to support our countries to train the women, provide opportunity, and those issues being embedded into our design of the program. Number three is that we really look at the internally how to have a policy setting, not only just general strategy, and a concrete implementation of the gender main policy, gender mainstream policy. For instance, like project preparation, we will have the checkpoint for the power empowerment of the women, gender balance. For the evaluation, we also look at the possibility how to have the results being evaluated after implementation of the program. So those are the basics of the our approach to dealing with the gender issue in general term.
Okay, thank you so much. But I want to know more, like, how does UNIDO promote gender equality? Like, for the rural women, for example, how does it promote gender equality in those areas?
Yeah. Of course, in the rural area, we could see, especially in Africa, also in Asia and some other regions, we could see most vulnerable group is women. And they start with lots of housework, kids raising kids, and less capacity, less opportunity to be involved in the process of the business. So our program, like industrial parks, when we build the industrial park and companies move in, the recruitment of the workers, we will look at the opportunity for women, for young ladies, and then give them opportunity for the training. We have extensive vocational training programs in 11 countries, a very large number of that. I do not want to repeat that. And we also have the vocational training for the camps, those refugees, particularly women, and they got opportunity for this kind of training. After that, they can got job, can get job. And also, we look at the rural area, develop some project. Like in Nigeria, we develop a small hydro program, actually, in a remote area. This small hydro supports one tea factory, and five villages being benefited from this small factory. We supported lots of women to get a job from this small hydro. So there are numerous such kind of programs we develop, pay special attention to the gender balance opportunities for women.
Thank you so much for the opportunity to have a chat with you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.